When you're moving over glaciers and high mountain terrain, it is important to master the rescue techniques required to deal with a fall into a crevasse. The simplest method, if there are enough people, is the team pull. If you are roped up, a crevasse fall is generally not a major incident. Normally, the consequences are minimal. It is essential that all the rope partners are alert in order to arrest the crevasse fall as quickly as possible. The principle behind the team pull is that those remaining outside the crevasse are able to collectively muster sufficient strength simply by walking backwards and by leaning back as they pull. 3, 4, or 5 people are usually enough to bring one person out of a crevasse. So if the fall has been arrested and the team members following have absorbed the load, the person nearest the crevasse should take charge of the rescue. First, they tie a prusik to the load line using an accessory cord, then tie this directly to their belay loop using an overhand knot. At this point, they can unclip the carabiner that was roping them on and can then carefully approach the edge of the crevasse. Having reached the edge of the crevasse, they prepare the lip as best as they can to make the rescue easier. First, this means removing any loose snow from the edge and breaking off any small cornices. Secondly, you can position an ice axe beneath and perpendicular to the load line to prevent the rope from cutting further into the lip of the crevasse. It is important to push the ice axe as far forward as possible and to secure it from falling into the crevasse by tying it to the rescuer or to the rope with a sling. Once the lip of the crevasse is prepared and contact has been made with the fall victim, the person at the head of the line can take over command and lead the team pull, giving clear commands of pull and stop. This can also be done using hand signals, providing that this has been communicated in advance. At the lip of the crevasse, you have to proceed with particular caution. This is when the tension on the rope is at its greatest. The rescuer can also assist the fall victim by offering a hand to get them over the lip as carefully and gently as possible. Once the fall victim is close to the edge of the crevasse, it is important to work slowly to avoid dragging the victim into the lip of the crevasse and possibly causing further injury. The team pull is without doubt the simplest rescue technique on a glacier. Nevertheless, it shouldn't be taken for granted and requires practice so that it can be performed in a coordinated manner. If it's not coordinated, the team pull can be a dangerous procedure. We recommend carrying out one team haul procedure on every tour. This will help develop the skills necessary to act quickly and efficiently in the event of an emergency. All alpinists should practice these rescue techniques on a regular basis so that they are fully prepared if an emergency arises.